Hello friends, to deliver the online classes we create a lot of good PowerPoint presentation with animation and design. We have to find a best way to disseminate the presentation. So SlideShare is a good online platform for publishing this type of presentation. That means SlideShare is used to share and store PowerPoint presentation. Okay. So before starting SlideShare, we need to log in. For that purpose, we require either a LinkedIn ID or Facebook ID or can start a new account in SlideShare. In this tutorial, we will explain how to do the login process and how we share files in SlideShare. So for this purpose, we need a browser. It can be Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, or Internet Explorer, anything. So either directly you can enter the website address, slideshare.net here on the address bar, or you can search in Google SlideShare. Then you can see www.slideshare.net. So this is the address bar address to get the SlideShare online platform. So if you click here, the browser, it will go to the SlideShare software, SlideShare website. So here you can see this is the first page and we have to log in first. I either log in, if you are a first time user, you can sign up. So during sign up, they will ask basic questions like the name, date of birth, gender, or email address, etc. So I am having the account early, so that I just enter by clicking login. So here you can see login with LinkedIn, login with Facebook, or login with your SlideShare account. So here I am entering my login details. So just log in to the site, login successful. So now it is logged in. So you can see the change here. Then you just click the upload button. Okay. So once you click the upload button here, a drop down menu will come like this. You can drag and drop the file, or by clicking the select file to upload, you can upload the file. Okay, and there are different other methods also. Here it is written drag and drop, or using Dropbox, Drive, Box, then OneDrive, Gmail, etc. These platforms, using these drives, we can directly insert the file. So usually we will have our PowerPoint presentation in the computer. So I am using that method to upload the file. So select the files to upload. So once it's clicked, menu will come like this. Then I stored my PowerPoint presentation here, the Kirchhoff law. So just click the Kirchhoff law here and open. Then some process is going on. Then the file name will come here. You can give some description here. Description in the sense for what purpose we are using this one. For example, if this is used to deliver for degree classes, then I can write the content here. So here I am using Kirchhoff law. Law in network theorem, network for degree classes. Then you can select the category. There are different categories are there. Arts, something you can see here. There are different categories are there. Depending upon our requirement, we can select. And here this is an educational PowerPoint presentation. So I am just selecting education. So education. Then you can save the privacy. You can set in three fashion: public, limited, private. So if you select private, this PowerPoint will be stored for private purpose only. Okay. So what will happen? This is just it act as a symbol storing platform. Then if we use the limited privacy, then you have to share the link. Only those who are having the share link can access the PowerPoint presentation. And if you tick the public, anyone can watch the PowerPoint presentation. Anyone can download the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, without any limitation. That is the advantage of public. So we can store and share the PowerPoint presentation in three different ways. One is public, second one is limited, and the last one is private. So I am using here public. Then tag is the keywords which are used to identify the PowerPoint presentation. So here it is Kirchhoff law are there. So definitely I want to apply. I need to apply Kirchhoff. Kirchhoff law. Okay. Then I can say network. Network. Then I can say anything. Physics. Physics. Like this, any word we can see. So if we search, you can see here. Anyone can search the word here. Depending upon the word, it shows a lot of PowerPoint presentation. So if we used Kirchhoff's law, if you type the Kirchhoff law here, one of the PowerPoint presentation will be ours. So that is the advantage. So after writing any tag, you can you have to give at least one tag, then only it will be in a searchable form. Then just click the publish. That's all. So publishing. The file is being published. Okay, so here now after publishing, we can share in different ways. Again, we can change the privacy setting after uploading. So if you want to share it, you can click here by share. You will get a link. Okay, so came here. Sorry. So in embedded form, we can share, or WordPress format is there. Then link is there. So if you want to share with the students, you can just select this link. Okay, this link is enough so we got the key. Sorry, we got the link, and that link can be shared with others. Okay, then if you click the link here, if you type the link here, it will automatically move to this side. Then you can maximize the screen. Then you can go to the next slides. Just press escape key, it will come like this. Then second, third, okay. Then you can download this one. Downloading Microsoft PowerPoint presentation. That presentation file itself will be downloaded. Okay, so you can simply save. So that PowerPoint presentation, you will get it. So this is the advantage of SlideShare online platform, which can be used to share and store PowerPoint presentation. Okay, hope it is clear.